All new tonight here on the Night Team. We're following this investigation. They don't know the cause yet, but fire investigators in Louisville say they know the large fire at this historic vacant church this weekend was no accident. And it was a tough blaze to get under control, taking crews nearly 2 hours to contain the flames, and at one point, part of the roof collapsed. Heather Fontaine is updating the investigation, what arson investigators have learned so far.
You never think of it being that happening to it.
It took 70 firefighters, 2 hours, and hundreds of thousands of gallons of water to put out these flames. 2 days later, Mother Nature continues to sprinkle on one of the first synagogues in Kentucky.
It was a real shock. It was like part of my heritage, you know, my kid as a kid growing up heritage. It's like, oh my gosh.
Rosalind Fishman was a congregant here in the 1950s and 60s before Kenneseth Israel Synagogue moved to Taylorsville Road. Her memories of its beauty stained by broken glass windows and a collapsed roof.
I'm very sad. Yeah, it's a sad thing.
Now red tape surrounds the building, a warning to stay out after part of the roof caved in while crews were on scene Saturday night. Even the arson unit finding safer ways to assess the damage.
They were actually up in the air yesterday morning.
Louisville Fire's Major Bobby Cooper says though there's been very limited access, arson investigators were able to get in through the side of the building Sunday morning.
They were able to take pictures. They were able to review burn patterns.
Major Cooper says they believe the fire started close to the roof or even in an attic area.
Any and all things are considered, you know, you think about things like lightning strikes, but we didn't really have anything like that evening. But that is stuff that they'll review.
The building has been vacant for some time. In fact, it was up for auction this month with bidding set to close later this week. Cooper confirmed there was no electricity running through the building before the fire.
That data collection now involves things like collecting video surveillance. So from surrounding buildings, surrounding companies.
The arson unit is still in the middle of a very thorough investigation, but if they do discover that this fire was set on purpose, the person or people responsible would face felony charges. For the Night Team, I'm Heather Fontaine.